Okay, yeah. And then to round it off, your best Nigerian accent. Hit it.
Gosh, you just put me on the spot like that. I wasn't sure if you were just. I wasn't sure what question she wants to ask me. If it's whether I was just. I don't know if I should end now, but I should continue to do it. I can also be an angry black, but angry Nigerian as you want me to be. And that's really it. You know, I'm just so happy to be on this show with Isiwa. And we just thank God for everything in life.
You know, so I know how to say your name, but most people cannot say your name. So how would you, how can you, like, tell them how to say it?
Okay, well, while there's different pronunciations of my name, mm-hmm. Noma is the actual pronunciation because okay. I am Igbo. Mm-hmm. But my older sister, when I was, like, so much, like, years ago, like, mm-hmm. maybe when I was, like, two, she created the name Nioma because she okay. couldn't say my name at the time.
Oh, wow.
So that's how Nioma came about. Okay. So a lot of people, like, shame me for her, and they're like, well, a lot of Nigerian people say, your name is spelled Noma, your name is not Noma spelled. And I'm like, no, Nioma, or like, that's what I'm going with here in the US, thank you.
Okay.
But yeah, just kind of stuck, and I'm just like, yeah, I love it.
Thank you so much for that, because when people like mispronounce my name, I'm just like, no, it's Isiwa, and I'm like, oh my God. Okay, so for those who don't know what you do and who you are, so how can you introduce yourself to my viewers?
Okay, well, I would say I am an online personality. I am also a vlogger. I'm also a host and MC. Mm-hmm. And I'm just kind of me. You know, I'm just, when it comes to like entertainment and lifestyle and, you know, just coverage of events mm-hmm. and things like that, I would just kind of I wouldn't box myself, but I'd say that I was like a vlogger lifestyle type of host.
Yeah, I know you come from a Nigerian household, so how do your parents take that? Like, because you're not doing the typical lawyer or doctor, you're
right.
going into hosting.
Well, actually, my parents didn't take it well at first. My mom threatened to not pay for college. My dad said that I should be a lawyer because I have a mouth and I talk a lot. And yeah, but eventually they kind of just decided to just support me because they realized that I was not going to stop. I was going to be persistent, and this is what I wanted to do since I was 11, and they knew that.
That's
so
good.
It's like, you can't really stop. You can't hold somebody back when they really want to do something.
Exactly. So how have you been able to build your character and build your brand and just keep going at it?
Well, I would say it kind of first started off with Facebook and Tumblr. Mm-hmm. I just kind of like, I've always like loved fashion and style and doing and following different trends, and I just put myself out there, and then people started to like love it, and people started to catch on to that. And then eventually, it's like, since I've always wanted to be an online personality and like a TV personality,
yeah.
I had a friend named Ike who I was just doing like little photo shoot, Tumblr
yes.
shoots with. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna start going on YouTube, and I wanna start like making like a fashion lifestyle kind of show, and let me, you know? And then he was just like, yo, you should do it. And then it started with YouTube, and then eventually it continued.
Yes, and then I know you and Ike, you guys have a show together.
Yeah.
So okay, first of all, I love the intro to it. It looks like Martin. Like, how did you guys come up with that concept?
When it comes to all the visual stuff, I take care of that. I just think more of like the content and what we're doing. That's what I take. That's what I do, content and marketing and things like that. And he does more of the visual aspect.
What is your show about for like those who haven't seen it yet? What do you guys, what is it? Is it skits? Is it comedy? Is it serious? Is it?
It's a little bit of all that. I mean, still to this day, we still can't really figure it out. We just label it as a variety show. So sometimes you'll see skits, sometimes you'll see lifestyle coverage events. Sometimes you'll see us talking about the latest trends and what happened. You'll see street trivia. You'll just see a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
So if you're like African, and not only African, but if you're a young adult who likes entertainment and, mm-hmm. and comedy and things like that, I'd say check out our show. Shameless plug. But
yes. So in one of your videos, you were so like transparent, and you've been able to become so like open with your followers. Like you say whatever you want. You're just like so personable. Cause when I watch, I'm like, yo, she could be my friend. Like,
really?
This girl is super cool.
Thank you. I think it kind of started with Snapchat, and then also I definitely want to give a shout out to Ike because, mm-hmm. Like I said, we started our show on YouTube together. Mm-hmm. And he helped me realize like my potential when it comes to my personality. Like, I've always used to be not self-conscious, but I was always like self-conscious of what I put out and
yeah.
what I'd say. And he just like, you know, you'd be a great personality, you'd be a great host.
Yeah.
Be more of yourself.
Exactly.
And I think Snapchat, I mean, although Snapchat is relatively new,
yeah.
I feel like Snapchat has really helped that too. Because for everybody, I think, when you have Instagram, it's that whatever you want to show. But
yeah.
Snapchat is more like, hey, here's me behind the scenes. Hey, here's me waking up in bed looking crazy, you know?
Right.
So I think that has helped. And then just generally, it's just like growing more and having confidence. I mean, I started my show when I was like, what? 16, 17,
yeah.
And now I'm like turning 21. So
yeah.
obviously at that time I was younger, and
yeah.
I'm growing more, and I'm mature, and I'm starting to know more of myself and who I am.
Yeah.
And now, you know, I'm just sharing it with the world.
I love that. So you do change your hair a lot. We're gonna talk about style. And in one of your videos, your mom snatched your wig off, and I thought it was hilarious. So what is it? You change, how many colors have you had?
I cannot count, and I can't even tell you at this time, but I do love to change my hair because I feel like, you know, we're young. It's time to be
exactly.
It's time to have fun. And with the wig thing, that kind of just started, like, I guess the end of last year because of my friend Nana. She's been doing wigs for a while. I'm just like, you know what, I should try that. Like, I literally just made a dread wig the other day.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, it just, I just love to switch it up and I just love to be different. So I see myself as doing that. I always see myself producing content. Mm-hmm. I have a passion for the youth and I have a passion for us creating and doing things that are just, you know, amazing. So I could be a producer, I could be a host, you know, it's just the possibilities are endless. I'm not limiting myself at this point. And really the sky's the limit. The future is bright.
You ready?
Yeah.
Sewing or gluing?
Sewing.
Kim or Kanye?
Kim. Kanye? Shit.
Sephora. Sephora or Mac?
Mac.
Egusi or okra?
Egusi. That's not, I don't even have to think about that.
What? Fish or shark?
Fish.
iPhone or Android?
iPhone.